And now to our major story of the day, everyone. Let's get down to business, shall we? Yesterday, the Senate approved an Eurobond request by the president. But the Senate gave note of warning that the federal government must slow down on its borrowing activities. The federal government has responded by saying they will slow down on borrowings going forward, especially in 2019. Nigeria's public debt increased from 21.73 trillion in December 2017 to 22.71 trillion at the end of the fourth quarter of 2018. The Debt Management Office's explanation is that the increase was largely accounted for by the increase in the domestic debt of states and the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja. Let's take a look at the nation's debt profile. From what you can see, from 2014 to 2018, you see there the breakdown for you. Now it has risen from about 4 years ago. So there are critical questions, though. Is Nigeria in trouble over its borrowings? Is it right to borrow? Are we borrowing too much? Can we bear the burden of the borrowings? Let's get talking, everyone, on this one. Grab a seat. Our partner tonight on the program, joining me from Abuja, is the director at the Debt Management Office, Ms. Patience Oniha, and also a former CBN Deputy Governor, Dr. Obadiah Mailafia, and Senator Shehu Sani is the chairman of the Senate Committee on Local and Foreign Debt. Thank you so much for coming to us on the program, everyone. So let me begin with you, Ms. Oniha. How did we get here? Your office, based on the report that you give, you break down the borrowing, the local one, the foreign one, what the states are borrowing, what the federal government are borrowing. How did we get here? 2014, it's been going up and it's not come down.
Okay, thank you very much, Shehu. Your answering your question straight may not give the public the full details. Okay, so borrowing is done on the basis of an approved legislations, one of which is the DMO Act as well as the Fiscal Responsibility Act. But in addition, on a year-to-year basis, there is the budget, the annual budget. So any keen follower of the budgets will know how the new borrowings arise. But in simple terms, to explain the debt stock does not just emerge in one day. So these are debts that we have been carrying for several years, and it just becomes incremental as we embark on new borrowing based on what the needs are in the budget. Okay, so when you say how did we get here, we got here because Nigeria needed, particularly since 2015, I will start from 2015, needed to augment its revenues, which had dropped significantly following the crash in crude oil prices, as well as the challenges with domestic production. So government's revenues more or less dropped by 50%, and there are expenditure lines from the budget. One is the payroll cost, there's the overheads, and then there's capital expenditure. Okay, so the effect of all of that was that government then needed to be able to meet its obligations regarding payroll, as well as commit to infrastructure, the development of infrastructure. For several reasons, we want to make Nigeria, you know, an attractive destination for foreign direct investment and for local investments, because we have several things working for our good in terms of local demand as well as resources that are available to us that we can, you know, where we have comparative advantage. So those are there, but the government also needed to generate employment, and infrastructure is one of those ways to generate employment. So the government's blueprint, which is the, you know, the ARGP, the Economic Recovery and Growth Plan, clearly stated what the focus would be. That in the short term, while the government is trying to enhance revenue in a period of recession, to meet those other obligations, especially investments in capital, it will come from borrowing. And we have seen over the 3 years that this administration has been in power, and the figures do speak for themselves, that there have been more releases for capital than has been before, and we can see those physical investments. They are evident. So borrowing didn't just arise, it is cumulative.
One of concern, sorry if I may butt in quickly. Ms. Oni, one of the major concern is how sometimes, especially so some of the figures released recently show that we in fact are partly borrowing to be able to bear the recurrent expenditure. If we are borrowing partly to pay salaries, to bear the burden of overhead, is this commonsensical in the scheme of things at the state of our economy presently?
I think very objectively, and that is very clearly articulated in the various pronouncements of government, as well as in the budget documents that are, you know, in the public domain. The objective is to use those borrowings to finance capital. That is the primary objective. Not that we go into borrowing because we want to finance overhead expenditure. No, that's not the intention. But revenues are the other side. And we keep saying, look, we must look at revenues. So when the budget is presented, there's expected revenues from various sources. And then there are the expenditure, like we said, they're in three categories, capital just being one of them. So when those are put together, there's a net. And we've been running as a government a fiscal deficit for several years, including when oil prices were, you know, above $110 per barrel. Okay, so those deficits have been funded largely through borrowing, and that accounts for the debt stock that we have.
Ms. Oni, let me allow Dr. Mailafia to come into the conversation now. You've been at the top offices in the CBN. Give us a sense of what you think has happened to Nigeria. Development experts around the world will say, look, for you to be able to meet up with the demands of developing some critical projects and infrastructure, you need to borrow. Is the federal government on track? Are they doing the right things in terms of what they're using the borrowings for and the rates at which the borrowings have come over the last 4 years or so?
Well, as a development economist, I cannot sit here and declare to the world that borrowing is a bad thing. I cannot say that. There are times when banks, firms, families, countries need to borrow. In fact, wise business people say it's better to use other people's money to grow a business than to use your own. So in principle, I would say, well, nothing wrong with borrowing, but what are you borrowing for? And the frequency of the borrowing, this is really what worries me. And if you look at the figures from 2014 at 11 trillion to 22 trillion in 2018, in a very short period of time, it's 100% jump. In 2005, when we settled the Paris Club debt, our total debt stock was $36 billion. And today we're almost exceeding that figure already. That worries me greatly. And if you go back into history, we fought the Civil War.
Dr. Mailafia. Dr. Mailafia, I'd like to pause you for a moment. Very interesting line of thought that you are. But we'll take a moment on the program. When we return, we still have Senator Shehu Sani, who is going to be speaking from the perspective of a legislature. And we continue to ask some very critical questions on the debt burden of Nigeria, the development plans of President Muhammadu Buhari and his cabinet. Are we on track? Are we in trouble? Critical questions, everyone. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.